Hey everybody, I'm back and I've got a new addition to the family. This is Jake Gyllenhaal. He's the youngest of our three dogs. We're now living here in Palm Springs, California, which is utterly beautiful and amazing. And I've been absent from YouTube for probably close to 3 years. I don't actually know because I haven't been counting. It's just a guess. And people have asked me, you know, why are you not on YouTube? And the truth is I just haven't felt inspired to kind of put the camera up and talk. But I am inspired now because in the last 2 years I've been working at the Killaby Center, just like really in the trenches with people, just on people with serious addictions, anxiety, depression, trauma, just real, real suffering. And in that place, there's just no room for kind of your standard kind of pithy, spiritual, let's feel good kind of stuff. Because this is where people are in the roughest part of their life, the worst part of their life. So if you try to sugarcoat it too much, they're just going to completely dismiss you because they just feel awful, especially like when they're in withdrawal. So I think that a lot of what's happened for me is that I've dropped even more of the kind of the pithy spiritual stuff, even though I was never really big on that to begin with. It just feels like really much more authentic for me now, what I have to say in a way that it's never been before. It's like in some ways I just don't really give a fuck about how I come across or the voice that I have. I have a unique voice in this, and I want to share that. There's a lot more love in my heart than ever before, with a beautiful family and a wonderful center with lots of employees and clients. But the reason that I wanted to talk today is because, you know, this whole thing about you've got to let it fall apart. Because when I sort of come back into the spiritual scene, what I see is that there's a whole kind of flavor or wave of spiritual teachings, which are, I feel, very like, they're just too safe in a way, because they sort of build upon the ego or the conditioning rather than just deconstructing it. For example, I was looking at a teacher's situation the other day, or the way that he was presenting himself, and it was just way, way too perfect. Like the whole image and everything was just really, really, really perfect, and it was almost like a scene out of some sort of sci-fi film. I mean, literally, the way that it was all put together. And you know, immediately I thought, this person has to be either a one or a three on the Enneagram. And so let's just take it away from spiritual teachers and talk just about what a one or a three is. So a one is a perfectionist, so it always has to get things just right. Only the positive, only good things. Bad is bad. And just getting things to look right and perfect, and if they're not right and perfect, they're really bad. That's kind of how a perfectionist operates. And then the three on the Enneagram is someone who has to excel above all others, right? To look good, to be ambitious, to be at the top of their game. And there's nothing inherently wrong with any of the nine types of the Enneagram, but it'll really sneak up on you and pull you in when you don't realize it. And when I saw this teaching, I thought, you know, either you're a one or a three on the Enneagram, and the whole fucking thing has got to fall apart. It has to fall apart for you to be really, really free in this lifetime. Let me explain what I mean by falling apart, because I didn't even know the possibility of it. My ego, when I used to listen to Eckhart Tolle, you know, here's a guy who had a history of being really, really angry at people. I mean, he would say he would bark at people left and right, and that his pain body was so angry all the time. And then, you know, he becomes enlightened, and he's like, at peace. You know, he just looks at peace. The problem is that my life wasn't like that. I didn't go around angry at people. In fact, just the opposite. For me, I was a nine on the Enneagram, so I was the peacemaker ego. Where he was the angry ego, I was the peacemaker ego. So I would avoid conflict with you at any cost. I would avoid or repress anger at any cost. There's just no such thing as anger inside me. At least that's what the ego used to say. Very much a people pleaser. So whereas Eckhart was going around just being angry at everybody, I was going around being very peaceful towards everybody. So for a long time I thought, well, God, you know, my awakening needs to look like Eckhart's does. And fuck no, it doesn't. Because my ego, that's what my ego did, is it presented itself as peacemaker. So in some ways, that whole thing has really fallen apart for me, like totally fucking fallen apart. So that, you know, in these last years when you haven't heard from me, I've just been pulling up repressed anger and just letting it, you know, just be here. And it's just completely liberating, and it destroys the entire idea for me that awakening is about being just being peaceful. Certainly there's an element of that, of peace in that non-dual realization that's here. But in terms of how I express myself in the world, you know, sometimes I'm angry as fuck. Sometimes if you provoke me, I'll just hit you right back with words. And the reason is because I've broken free, that the whole thing fell apart for me. And I think that that's what I'm trying to get people to see, is like to be really, really radical with this spirituality, and don't follow what your conditioning has always told you is true. There's another group of folks, mainly spiritual seekers that I see, but some teachers who are sixes on the Enneagram, and so they're very anti-authority. So they'll pick at spiritual teachers because they're afraid of the authority that they represent, and they don't trust them. But the thing is, man, just look, let that whole thing fall apart. Let the whole thing, all of your distrust and your fear, let it come to the surface and let it just destroy you completely. Because to me, that's when liberation is really happening, is when the thing that you've been running on, the particular conditioning, whether it's a peacemaker ego or a perfectionist ego or a distrustful anti-authority ego or whatever it is, it has to fall apart. It has to fall apart. And that's just a story, right? Because they're all stories. But literally, it's almost like you have to realize one day that it isn't working and it isn't what you are. You have to watch the whole thing crumble. And you got to feel everything under that, because there's a pain under all of that. All that trying to be perfect and keep things together and make everything look just right, there is pain underneath that. And underneath that desire to look good, like the Enneagram 3, like to excel and to make everybody think that you're on top of the world and doing so well, you know, like that you're the head of the corporate ladder, or you've got the shiniest teaching or the shiniest business or the shiniest whatever, that whole thing has got to fucking fall apart for you. And the same is true for any of the types or any ego structure. You know, and I'm not even trying to create some seeking gain. What I'm trying to do is to inspire you, is to don't fall for what has always been. Like, don't fall for that. Like, use inquiry or use whatever tools you have to just literally explode open all of these myths, these boxes, these false identities. And also, when you do have a powerful awakening, my God, that's the time that it should fall apart for you. It should start falling apart right there for you to build up something out of that that just looks like the same conditioning that you always brought to it. And that's not anything new. That's not anything fresh. That's not anything liberated. You know, so I just want to get under your skin. I want you to challenge your spiritual teachers. I want you to challenge yourself. I want you to challenge the path that you're on and ask these hard questions about, what am I inheriting from a spiritual teaching that just happens to be from the ego of the teacher? Or what am I bringing to my present life, which is just more of the same conditioning? Am I just trying to build up a perfect world of spirituality because I'm a perfectionist? Am I trying to look good for everybody else because I'm a 3 on the Enneagram? Am I still wanting to be in control of everything because I'm the boss, like the Enneagram 8? And if you don't know what the Enneagram is, I really suggest reading it, because it can be highly enlightening. But mainly, I just want to say, let it all fucking fall apart. You know, the moment when you realize you're really, really raw, like you're really vulnerable, and because you've just been opening yourself to every emotion that comes up, and you've been watching all of those contractions in your body just break open, and you just realize that you have no self-protection anymore, and that your old patterns don't work anymore because they've fallen apart. You know, that is what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about anything but that when it comes to liberation. And just one more word as I come back to the spiritual scene. I see a lot of talk about kind of just recognize awareness, and then that somehow is the be-all, end-all. Like you just have a shift and you recognize that you are the non-dual awareness. Do not fall for that. That's only the beginning, because it all has to fucking fall apart after that. The whole ego structure will and will fall apart if you just remain open to the inevitable of that. And don't believe that because you've had an experience or because somebody else had an experience, that that's really what liberation is. It's just a shift into presence or awareness. There's a lot more to be seen, and a lot more shit is going to fall away and break apart and fall apart after that. And that's really, God, that's where the juice is. Like, that's where the whole point of this is to go to those greater depths, like those greater sense of freedom, where you feel naked and you're just, you don't even know how to talk anymore. Like, you don't know how to talk because you're so raw and open and vulnerable, and there's just no framework for which you feel like you're trapped in, and there's nothing you're trying to hold together. And you're not trying to be enlightened, and you don't know what enlightenment looks like, and you're not interested in other people and whether they're enlightened or not. Just blow the whole thing open. That's all. However way you can do that, just do that. That's what I suggest.